Climate change mitigation describes efforts to reduce climate change through either decreasing the sources of greenhouse gases or increasing the sinks of greenhouse gases. So agriculture is important to climate change mitigation because agriculture accounts for 1/3 of all of our greenhouse gas emissions. These emissions are from 3 different gases. So the first is most familiar, it's carbon dioxide. That comes from energy use, so that would be the energy that we need to make synthetic fertilizers and herbicides and pesticides. It comes from land clearing for agriculture, so when we cut down forests or burn forests to make room for agriculture, we release all that carbon that's locked up in the trees into the atmosphere as carbon dioxide. In addition to carbon dioxide, agriculture produces 2 particularly potent greenhouse gases. The first is methane. So methane comes from flooded rice paddies. It's organic matter breaking down in the absence of oxygen because it's underwater. And it comes from cows. It comes from ruminant digestion. The other potent greenhouse gas that agriculture emits is nitrous oxide. And that comes from us putting fertilizers on fields. So when we put fertilizer on fields, that has nitrogen in it, that helps our plants grow. But it also, if it's just sitting on the soil, it can react with oxygen and become nitrous oxide. There are a variety of ways in which agriculture can reduce greenhouse gas emissions. For carbon dioxide, we can fix the footprint of agriculture, so we can not clear any more land and intensify agriculture on the land that we're currently growing on. We can also use renewable energy to make those fertilizers and pesticides and herbicides. And finally, we can increase the carbon content of the soils by taking organic matter and incorporating into the soils through things like low-till agriculture, no-till agriculture, and cover cropping. For nitrous oxide, we need to get better at applying fertilizers, so more precise. So this includes both not putting too much fertilizer on our field, which we tend to do in developed countries just to ensure a good crop. And it also includes splitting that application into a couple different applications so that there's never a lot of nitrogen sitting on the soil ready to react with oxygen and create nitrous oxide. For methane, you can intermittently drain rice paddies, and that tamps down on the methane production from that biodegrading organic matter. And also, there are ways in which you can both manage manure coming from ruminants, from cows, and also amend their feed to cut down on methane emissions. I'll give 3 suggestions for how you can reduce your own personal greenhouse gas emissions footprint in your diet. So the first is to vote. Federal action is really needed to address climate change, and it's needed in 2 different ways. First, to either directly or indirectly set a price on carbon. When there's pollution, you need to pay a price or somehow clean it up. And it's the same thing with carbon dioxide. So we need to set that price, and then we can use that price to incentivize and pay farmers to do the kind of climate change mitigation that I was just talking about. The other thing that having a federal government strong on solving the climate crisis does is it pulls in the rest of the nations of the world. And it ensures accountability for us. The U.S. has traditionally lagged in climate change emission reductions. And it importantly pulls in rapidly developing economies like China and India, who have greenhouse gas footprints that are near ours or if not larger at this point. The second thing you can do is reduce your consumption of red meat. There's nothing that you put on your fork, likely, that has more greenhouse gas emissions than does beef. So it comes from the energy to create the feed, to the methane emissions from the cow, to the entire cold chain that you need to get the meat from the cow to your supermarket. If you can go vegetarian, that's even better. But if not, at the very least, cutting down red meat helps. And finally, you can reduce food waste. So 30 to 40% of the food that we grow is wasted. So in developing countries, this food waste often occurs from field to market. But in developed countries like the United States, this food waste disproportionately occurs at the consumer end. So it occurs in our refrigerators, it occurs at our restaurants, and in our supermarkets. So just being smart about the food you buy, making sure you use it up, freeze it if you're not gonna use it, and that just ensures that the food that we've already paid that carbon or greenhouse gas price for is actually consumed and useful.